There you go, at 105-19 is the 37 Fav, is the former home, one of the homes of Dizzy Gillespie, who is literally two blocks away from the home of jazz great as well, former home, Louis Armstrong. Located in Corona, Queens. Now you would never know. It's actually not even a national landmark. Home should be a national landmark, honestly. Gillespie lived from 1917 until 93, died at the age of 75. A jazz great. The trumpet, piano, vocals. Influenced many guys like Miles Davis, John Faddis, Fats Navarro. Considered one of the greatest jazz trumpeters of all time. Being influenced as well by Louis Armstrong. Maybe they were best buddies since they lived so close to each other. I often say this, do people know, like, who lived in that building? Or do people know, who walked the streets that you live in? The streets that you walk on. This is how the street, I'm going to give you an idea of how the street looks like. Or where he grew up in, or where he lived. It's funny because he actually, I don't get exactly the whole gist of it, the whole story, but he is buried next to his mother in Flushing Cemetery, which is also where Louis Armstrong is buried. But he's buried next to his mother in an unmarked grave. Now, I don't know exactly what the scenario is. Is it maybe because the family doesn't want any visitors? Like, I hear stories about the Whitney Houston grave, for example, where it's a marked grave, but they have patrol officers there for the sole purpose of making sure no one goes in and visits the grave of Whitney Houston. So I don't know if that's the case. Maybe, because he was a star, maybe they didn't want visitors, but just kind of feels, or maybe Dizzy didn't want it himself, but it kind of feels like a sad situation or a sad story as to why he never had a marker. There are videos out there where the grave would be, because he's buried next to his mother. But you really need to devote your time to try to pinpoint it accurately.